a stone's throw from historic Monument Circle in downtown Indianapolis, we are at the beautiful Lucas Oil Stadium. Today, the curtain falls on the regular season, and we've got a good one in store between the Houston Texans and the Indianapolis Colts. Here's the former UCLA Bruin, Kyme Fairbairn, to get this one started. And we are underway from Indianapolis. Taken at the goal line. And they're going to start in a hole. It's Ryan. And he's got Pierce. The 40. And they're going to.
We'll block them away. And whether the receiver has to elevate or extend, now he has a clear path to the football with the defender usually on his back.
Here's the first carry for Austin Eckler. And able to fight forward inside the. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed, but they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. On third down, here's Eckler. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. A stop there on third. They could have held him to 3 on this opening drive. Now they have to bow their necks on first and goal.
And if I'm looking at this from the offense's point of view, that's a big-time pickup right there. And I go right at him with another momentum play. I go quickly and attack them, because right now they probably have their heads down a little bit since they didn't stop them on third down.
This one finds Pierce on the out route. This afternoon. Well, they. Time. Not only did they not get it, they went backwards. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. From his end zone, here's Tre'Mond Smith. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. First carry now for Rex Burkhead. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down. These two teams, they met in Houston earlier in the season with the Texans coming out on top. So if they can find a way to win here in Indianapolis, they would take the season series 2-0. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. To throw is Brady. That's caught by Howard. And And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. 15 yards, the Texans pick up the first down.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
First run of the game here for Damian Pierce. And a lane slow and materializing there as he'll get maybe a yard up to the 45. Well, this defense for the Colts, they were very strong in the win last week over the Giants.
And one of the key things you always look for when you're evaluating a defense is how opportunistic are they? How many takeaways do they get per game? And how about last week's game? That number, 6. Absolutely phenomenal performance. They were on top of their game right from the first snap.
They follow up the first down 1 yard run with a minimal gain of 2. Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
Meanwhile, Brady's throw taken in by Collins. Touchdown, Houston! Nico Collins, 44 yards! And the Texans are an extra point away now from moving out in front. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And they take the lead here at 7-6. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him 3 more. The Indy offense at the line and set to go as we grind toward the end of the season here, and they haven't had the season that they had hoped. So let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think if you look into the upcoming draft, tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league, and big people always end up winning games for you.
Running on first down, Eckler. And a good burst there gets him 7 up to midfield. The Colts had 5-11 on the year. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. And I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
First carry of the game here for Royce Freeman. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That's good for 21 yards and a first down. Freeman again. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Off the play fake. Here's Ryan. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone.
I don't care what game it is. Everyone's always looking for an early advantage, an early break, and they almost had one there. That should have been an interception. Nice catch. Just couldn't get his feet down in bounds.
And offensively lucky to have that one back. On third down, Ryan. He'll get this out wide to Eckler. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Colts unable to convert here on fourth down. And this Texans defense stands tall. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed. Now Brady. That's complete to his running back, Burkhead. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 16 yards on that one, and also a Texan first down.
If you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Throw complete there, Rodgers. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving. Brandon, watching their tape from last week, I saw plenty of plays like we just saw there, forcing incompletions. It was key in their win last week.
On second down, here's Pierce. Oh, a nifty juke there. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. 11th rushing touchdown on the year as his guys are able to extend their lead. Fairbairn good with the extra point, and the lead is up to 8. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away.
Taking it about the 1. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. And now a stoppage, and looks like we have a Colt who was shaken up on that last play.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this goal?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Now it's Ryan. Pass complete. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yards. So a 1st and 10 now in Houston territory, right at the 40. Here's Ryan to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he fires one that's intercepted. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they will score.
just extend the play. They're getting outside the pocket, but he throws a costly pick six.
Yeah, he's trying to find someone open. You're exactly right. He wasn't looking to run. He was looking to throw. The result, not good for him. They were more than happy on the defensive side to gather that one in and take it to the house.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
This fielded right at the goal line. And able to get this out to the 25.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. They started on the ground with Eckler. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30. An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports.
Eckler going to get it again on second down.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12. On first down, Ryan. He'll get this to Eckler. Oh, he's got some breathing room. The 30.
And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
...to 21-17.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. On the return, here comes Smith out of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
Second and 5 now. Oladokun. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Give him 17 on the pickup there, and the Texans also get a new set of downs.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out, battle just about every time. And you've got guys who can flat out run. Sometimes all you say in the huddle is go. They ran the fly route, took the shot downfield, just unable to connect.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Out of the shotgun, a give to Burkhead.
And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47.
Of course, they had the option, and they choose to not take the penalty.
They like the results of the play that they just ran, and they elect to let them stand.
Pierce now up the middle.
And he's going to be called. So erase the flag. They decline it.
And did they use the big eraser, or was that...
Well, I was thinking the, like, the 2x2-inch ones that you can buy and use in addition to the pencil.
And those last forever.
A long time.
No doubt.
Now a dump off here complete. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
First and 10, it's Pierce. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Looking to throw, Oladokun. That's caught. It's Chris Moore. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts' 22-yard line. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is to plunge forward. Here's Rodgers now in the jet sweep. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose.
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. Calling a gain of 1 yard, and that'll bring up what looks to be 3rd and inches. Can't be more than 1/2 a foot.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
And they got 3 yards. That's enough. A conversion, and now it's 1st and goal.
Brandon, they're still in the lead, but momentum's certainly been going the opposite direction. So to me, that's a really important pickup there on 3rd down.
Try and regain some confidence, and you're right. They need to stem the tide a little bit. That certainly helped. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
That's good power football on 1st and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there, but that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
Running it out of the gun with Pierce. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer, and he's down to about the 2.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a 2nd touchdown already in the 1st half.
They had that one earlier. It was bidding for a 2nd. The Texans on 3rd down. A perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. They're looking at a 3rd and goal here.
To throw, Oladokun.
And got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Houston. O.J. Howard, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Texans go up by 2 touchdowns. Well, with that touchdown pass, I'm going to bring up a point from earlier. When do we turn to the rookie? Well, he's looking pretty good right now.
Yeah, I love the fact that the fans are bringing that up. Because I'm not the head coach, okay? So he's got to deal with it. But I think it's a legitimate question. With the way their season is going, I think now is the time to turn the page and let him get some starts before this season is over.
So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away.
From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Offense at the line and set to go.
A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they look up and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, and I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
2 minutes remaining in this 1st half of football. Only needing 2 yards on 2nd down. stays up. But in the end, the pressure too great, and he goes down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
But that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, but they have to keep getting in his face, not let him get his feet set up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey.
Now that sack backs Ryan and the Colts up a bit here, facing a third and long.
They'll look to throw. He'll take a shot downfield for Pittman. And it's intercepted. Desmond King picks it. And the Texans are going to take over at their own 30-yard line.
And I think this is a situation where a quarterback coach in the sideline is going to talk to a signal caller and say, listen, it's third and long, and it's still early in the game. Let's not force things here. If we don't feel good about it, let's just shut something down and punt the football.
But one thing we certainly know, he likes to take those risks deep downfield during games, coverage or not. The coverage was there on that one. No catch, but he's also fortunate. No turnover either.
Oladokun's throw complete here, pulled in by Howard.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
Oladokun looking to pass once more.
That'll be caught. It's the tight end, Howard. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. A give to Burkhead on first down. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
He's got it to Collins, complete.
And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans.
Amari Rodgers.
As the first half is winding down,
and the Texans will extend their lead here just before halftime.
Extra point by Fairbairn. Opens up now to 22 points.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fields it right around the goal line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive.
And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Final play of the half. It's Ryan. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that is 1-sided game so far. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. It's the Texans in front, and they're going to get the football first as we are back underway in the third quarter. Out of the end zone comes Smith. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
They're obviously right now in the driver's seat, comfortably ahead. They've scored on a couple straight possessions, Charles, and I mean, for them, I guess it's just more of the same, right? Keep doing what you've been doing.
Yeah, it's not typical for us to see games out of reach in the third quarter. Right now, they're unstoppable in this one. And seeing how they just came out onto the field, it does appear like they're done scoring points in this one. They look awfully confident.
A second down run for Burkhead. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's back.
In the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe just a little inspirational speech, who knows, but looks like they're ready to go.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he's going to find it.
Used to check it down to them or maybe dump off passes, but this guy, they use him to stretch the field, don't they?
He stretched it right there, turned it into a really nice game. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Burkhead gonna run straight ahead here, and he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 41 yards on the ground for him so far.
Now, that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there. When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
Pierce will try to pick it up, and he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to first down, and that's exactly what he did.
First and 10, here's Oladokun. That's caught right side by Rogers.
Everything that was discussed at the half, just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
They'll run the jet sweep now. Rogers trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Up the gut with Burkhead. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Oladokun. And got his... And the Texans take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field. Well, to put it mildly, he's been able to dice up this secondary all game long. And this time, that was a missile that he threw into the end zone and adding another touchdown to his ledger.
And I think we see these youngsters develop a lot quicker than we ever have, because when they get started season pros earlier in their career. How about this one here? If they win this ball game, a game ball definitely coming from his head coach.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. A CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history, and that's try to come back from a four-possession deficit.
And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Indianapolis.
So if you're going to do that, you think to yourself, we need points right here on the opening drive. But even in their best game plan, did they expect it to be a one-play drive and put the points on the board? Probably not.
No, probably not, but they got it in a big way. And they're going to get the two. Zone, and that cuts the lead a bit further. Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. On the return, here comes Smith out of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Still operating with a comfortable lead despite the score a moment ago as they begin first and 10. Up past the 25 to the 26, a gain of 5.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up 5, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
It's Oladokun on first down.
Got it complete to Rodgers.
Yards remain on second down. Oladokun looking to pass it.
And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete.
They go with the empty set there. 5 receivers in the formation. Normally, you want to have a running back in the block, but in this case, he's lined up to the right, and he ends up getting the football. A lot of confusion calls defensively, and it turns into a big play.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage.
I tell you, he brings the wood when he comes flying up in run support. He may be a safety, but he hits like a linebacker.
That loss of 3, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's 2nd and 13. Oladokun to throw. Open man is Jordan, the tight end. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 18. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
Pierce takes it straight ahead, and he'll get this one down to about the 17. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. And Pierce gets it again on 2nd down.
And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone.
65 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times. Here's Oladokun.
And he fends him off. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Finally hauled down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him.
First down, a bit of a disaster. And now on 2nd and goal, back even further. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him.
It's also a gain of 9.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. As a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Flushed out right. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here.
That is certainly one way to frustrate a quarterback. Run those extra defenders on the field. Dime package, lots of speed, no space to fit into football.
Fairbairn able to put this one through, and that will extend their lead even further. Only 3 points there, but I got to think, at this point in the third quarter, that's all you're really looking for.
And right now, the lead is 3 touchdowns and 3 two-point conversions, so you and I both know a huge order for the best of teams. And from what we've seen so far, hard to believe that that's a likely scenario. 3 two-point conversions, that's difficult.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. Now it's Ryan. Flush to his right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away. And now it's 3rd.
Well, they approach this drive with a lot of confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first 2 throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on 3rd down to get their momentum going again.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Wait a second, that's got to be a mistake. They declined it.
That doesn't make any sense, right? I mean, it doesn't at all, because you want that penalty, all right? They just picked up a 1st down, right? You want the penalty.
I am so confused right now.
And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line.
1 quarter remains here as the regular season starts to wind down. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Play action, Ryan. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And this is caught. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. An explosive 38-yard pickup.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
Now a throw to the end zone on 1st down, but it winds up incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them, because just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Eckler is into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis.
So the rushing touchdowns continue to stack up, CD. That now 15 for him on the year.
And give him a ton of credit for staying healthy, being a smart runner, and it's showing just how important he's been to his team. He's got to be their MVP at this point in the season. And those votes may have been turned into league MVP votes when it's all said and done.
Sanchez now, he'll kick it away following the touchdown. Out of the end zone comes Smith. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And this one has gone pretty well to form. They've come in, had little problem thus far, and now they'll try to polish things off in the 4th. Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down.
So 4th quarter, a nice run there to start this drive. Charles, what do you think the split will be here between run and pass?
Well, partner, I think it'll lean towards the run, but this is also not a time where you just totally do that. You still have to possess the ball, move the sticks, and keep the clock moving as well. So they'll run their offense, But yeah, when they have a chance to run it, they'll do that a little bit more.
And this offense on third down today, they've been outstanding. 7 first downs and 8 tries. Here it's 3rd and 3. Try to lay one up deep. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down. Here's Cameron Johnston now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the 4th quarter. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Good open field tackling there. A 50-yard punt followed by just a 1-yard return. And the Colts are going to take over, albeit deep in their own territory. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. Facing a big 4th quarter deficit here, things not looking good. You know, this offense, though, they've been in the top half of the NFL so far this season, but in this one, well, their defense has really struggled. It'll be a gain of just 1 yard, and that's going to bring up 2nd down. Ryan. This will be taken in by Michael Pittman. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. 23 yards the pickup there. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Here's Ryan. He'll take a shot downfield for Pittman. And a penalty. Again on 2nd and 10, it's Ryan. That's going to be caught by Allie Cox. And he's going to be taken down with another 1st down as the stop's made at the Texans' 44-yard line. They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it. And it's 2nd down. Throwing on 2nd and 8, Ryan. And he's going to be intercepted for the 3rd time thus far. The ball comes out, and the Texans are going to take possession as the big man get the oxygen tank. Costs it right back up the other way.
I've seen this happen in an NFL game, and boy, did it cost someone. San Francisco.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a 2nd look at this just to make sure. He was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable 4th quarter lead. Just 1 yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Pierce gets this one running right. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. 74 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Now a handoff for Pierce. And they will only muster 1 yard here to the 38. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the 4th quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it. And the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
25 yards the pickup there, and also a 1st down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a 1st down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I think sometimes when you're trying to get after the quarterback, maybe it's better to be lucky than great, because I think on that one, he's just trying to get upfield and rush the passer.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. O.J. Howard, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game.
And the Texans are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead.
Fairbairn. And they open the lead up now to 25. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away.
This taken in at the goal line. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive.
Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one.
16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
And with this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
But we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline, because he certainly wants him to finish this one out the way they started it. He doesn't want to give up any soft completions.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today.
Picked off by Christian Harris. And the Texans are going to get the football here at their own 40.
The clock, they know the lead that they have, and all they're doing is playing pass on every down.
Playing the pass, picking it off, and now big time in the driver's seat. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive.
Now they are really in the driver's seat here, enjoying this lead late in the fourth quarter. The defense does have all three timeouts, but at this point, doesn't look like it's going to matter much. 31, second and nine. And Pierce gets it again on second down.
And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the one-yard pickup. Sets up third and six.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Now Oladokun, third and long. Got a man able to find Rodgers. He's got the first down and more. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly...
So now, following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10. And they'll take a knee as the clock runs under a minute to play.